Hey, 49ers fans, I'm Thomas Mott. Welcome into Chat Sports, and today, let's put a grade on the 49ers versus Denver Broncos preseason game that just happened literally less than a day and a half ago, depending on when you were watching this video. So again, 49ers, Broncos, that was an interesting game. We're going to get into the whole thing. Here's how we're going to do it. Full offense grades, defense grades, special team grades. Then we'll get into some individual grades as well. You bet your bottom dollar. We're going to be talking about Jimmy Garoppolo at the very beginning of the individual grades as well. Before we jump in, really quickly, I need you guys to go over to our official 49ers YouTube channel here for Chat Sports, www.chatsports.com/49ers. We're almost to 1,000 subscribers. If we get to 1,000, that means we can start producing a lot more daily 49ers content. I know you guys are out there. Like 18,000 of y'all watch these videos. So go subscribe to the official Chat Sports 49ers page. All right, without further ado, let's start with the offensive grade. All right, should we give the offense a total grade? What should we give them? How about a C minus? Okay, I know, right? It might be a little bit high. A lot of people have seen, so I read a lot of online grades saying D minus F. Here's the deal. 24 points. The passing was absolutely atrocious. We're going to get into that. 93 yards passing. They did have 185 yards rushing. Means they had 278 total yards and were 2 for 4 in the red zone. The rushing is why it was a C minus. Because for as bad as it was throwing the football, and Jimmy Garoppolo was absolutely terrible. C.J. Beathard basically remained the same. Nothing too special there. The run game was absolutely fantastic, which is why they get a C instead of a D. This is going to be a very good running football team. We knew that going in, especially with Tevin Coleman, especially with Breida, but even a guy like Mostert looked really good the other day. So listen, we can get into the passing game. It was really bad. I have a lot of concerns, but overall, the offensive grade needs to be a C minus instead of a D because the running attack was just that good. Overall defensive grade. Let's go with a B plus. This was actually pretty good. 15 points allowed, 102 yards passing, 113 yards rushing. Denver had a total of 215 total yards. It was 0 for 2 in the red zone. No Buckner, no Bosa, no Ford. But the D line looked really, really solid. And might I just go ahead and throw this out there? Solomon Thomas is having a very good preseason, a quiet preseason. But a good preseason. In the plays that he was in, he's getting pressure. He's getting off the ball well. This is a guy that would be like an icing on the cake player for this 49ers defense. Because we expect Buckner and we expect Bosa and we expect Ford to all dominate, right? Eric Armstead in there as well. But if you have another rotational defensive line player like Solomon Thomas, who has the talent, we know that. Got to put it all together. If he could emerge as well, the defensive line gets all the more better. But again, he looks very, very good. The secondary was good. Wasn't great overall. Tart looked absolutely fantastic. He seemed locked in, looked really, really good in coverage. But the secondary, again, had its moments where it looked like a Witherspoon had a nice open field tackle. He looked like he's going to be fine there at the other cornerback spot. The safeties, again, I guess we're going to have to wait and see. We talked a lot before about it being a top 10 defense, and I don't know if it's top 10 defense material. The front seven to me is top 10 defense material. Is the secondary top 10 defense? I don't know. Could we be the 12th ranked defense in the NFL? Maybe the 15th ranked defense in the NFL? I think those are very real possibilities, but at least the front seven looked good. The linebackers, Greenlaw looked really good as always. So I'm very positive on the defense as a whole, and we'll stick with a B+ for their grades. You know what? Let's do special teams as well. All right, special team grade. A, can we go, how many pluses do we have? 5 pluses. Plus. And all I'm going to say, Mitch Wisnowski, if you actually watch the game, you know what I'm talking about. You actually watch the whole game, you know what I'm talking about. How about Wisnowski with the tackle, baby? Jeez. What's his tackle rating going to be like on Madden now? It's got to go up, right? I mean, it has to go up a lot. Okay, I mean, other special teams was good as well, not just Wisnowski's one open field tackle. Robbie Gould was good from 41. He's basically automatic. We talked about this a lot on this show, that he's going to be fantastic. Really glad they were able to sign him to a long-term deal. And Richie James played well on punt returns, and it looks like that could be a way for him to make the squad at the wide receiver position, because again, you get further down the depth chart, what else can you do for me, right? Not just catch passes, can you return kicks, can you play special teams? And Richie James looks like he could be a potentially, a roster guy because of that. So again, overall grades, offense is C-, defense is B+, and then special teams is A+++++ because of that open field tackle, which again, if you watch the game, I know some of you guys don't watch preseason. I know, but some of you guys do. You watched it. You guys saw what happened. All right, well, one more time. Be sure to subscribe to our 49ers official Chat Sports YouTube channel, www.chatsports.com/49ers. We're close to 1,000. I want to see 1,000 after this video. Like, by a day after this video, 1,000 subscribers have got to be on the Chat Sports page, or I don't know what I'll do. Like, I'll still make videos here, but that's go subscribe to the Chat Sports page. Okay, all right. Let's start with some individual grades here. We have to go with Jimmy Garoppolo, okay? F. You know, it's as simple as that. I know he's still recovering. Here's my issue with Jimmy Garoppolo. It's not just the fact that the interception was really, really bad. It's not just the fact he's having passes deflected in front of him. He's not looks like he's on the same page with his wide receivers. My big concern is the knee. Okay, that was like the first time we've seen him with actually people diving around his legs. Looked very stiff, looked very, very not fully confident in the health of the knee. Like if he got hit down there, he could re-tear it. We have seen this recently with Carson Wentz. They rushed Carson Wentz back too fast in Philadelphia, and his first couple of games, it was the same thing. The talent was still there, but he's just worried about getting hit again, and that's what I saw from Jimmy Garoppolo. Now, we can't give him a better grade because of that. It has to stay as an F because, again, 1 for 6, 0 yards, the one really bad pick. I don't know what he was doing there. And a 0.0 quarterback rating are all factual evidence that this was a bad start for Garoppolo. And at the same time, he's not looked that great in training camp, right? I mean, you talk to anybody who's actually there. He had a day like 2 days ago, 3 days ago. It was last week. He had 5 straight interceptions on 5 straight plays, okay? This whole Jimmy Garoppolo is going to ball out this year is losing a little bit of steam. I'm a Jimmy Garoppolo fan. I've said before, I think if he's healthy, he's going to play well. But at the same time, doesn't look healthy. And right now, he looks like he's in his head a little bit too much. This is a concern for the 49ers. We have to keep an eye on Jimmy Garoppolo going forward. But again, I would give him an F because it was just that bad. What would you guys give him? I'm very curious. You know, Jimmy Garoppolo's the quarterback, very polarizing. What grade would you give him? Do you need a little bit of leeway? Just like see him out there, give him a D-? I can't see anyone giving him a C. Type Jimmy Garoppolo and then a grade down below so I can see what you guys are going to go ahead and grade Jimmy G. All right, moving on here. Let's go ahead and give a grade to Tevin Coleman. Remember, you're going, Tevin Coleman wasn't even the leading rusher. Mostert was great. He was like 6 for 58 and a touchdown and carried his team big time in the third quarter. I could have graded him. But what I saw from those first couple of runs from Tevin Coleman, again, 3 carries for 21 yards. He had that 12-yard run. He had the 7-yard run per yards per carry. He looks like a guy who's ready to assume the number one running back role. Remember, behind Devontae Freeman forever down there in Atlanta, now he can truly shine as the number one back. I think he took full advantage of it in his time out there against the Broncos. It was a very short sample size, but I was very impressed with Tevin Coleman. I think Tevin Coleman is going to be a huge addition for this offense. A+ for Tevin Coleman. All right, next, let's go ahead and do a wide receiver. Again, I thought about doing Richie James. I thought about doing Mostert because he was like the leading receiver, but mainly he was the leading receiver because he had like a really good screen pass that he took for like, what was it, like 31 yards or whatever it was. So we'll actually do Kendrick Bourne because Jalen Hurd didn't do anything. Obviously, Debo Samuel had that one nice reverse, which was pretty good. But other than that, he didn't do much. It was a rough night for wide receivers. And it's a rough night for wide receivers because the quarterbacks played so poorly. The only receiver, again, who had any sort of bright spot was Kendrick Bourne. We give him a B- because he had that nice catch for the touchdown, but he also dropped the wide open pass from C.J. Beathard. You cannot do that. It's like Beathard's only good throw. You got to catch those balls. So again, the 2 catches, 27 yards. He had 3 targets and a long of 26, including the 1 touchdown. I thought he was fine, right? I thought he's a B- guy. I think he's probably going to make the squad. But again, so I was trying to actually rate a player, rate a wide receiver here. He's the only one I could really pick. So we're going to go with a B- for Kendrick Bourne. I just said he's gonna make the roster. What do you guys think? Type yes or Y down below for yes and down below for no if Kendrick Bourne is going to make the 49ers official 53-man roster. Next one here, I really wanted to do the entire offensive line. We'll pick on Joe Staley even though he's in there for just a little bit. He gets a D+, but in reality, this is a D+ for the entire offensive line because, good Lord, Bradley Chubb ate their lunch. Bradley Chubb had a field day. You mentioned the strip sack of C.J. Beathard. They were teeing off not just on Garoppolo, but on Beathard as well, and it was mainly due to that left side of the offensive line. Again, I pick on Joe Staley here, so you'll see it on the graphics. D-plus for Joe Staley. I still think he's going to be fine. A little bit old, but still going to be fine. It's a D-plus for the entire offensive line because it was just that bad. And that's the other concern, right? They can run the ball just fine. The receivers look like they'll be decent enough. But if Garoppolo is still worried about getting injured and they can't keep him darn healthy, right? Or they can't keep him darn upright, so the people are hitting him and going bodies everywhere and he's trying to move around the pocket and getting sacked, it's going to be a long year, guys. Okay, the offensive line has got to improve. It looked really, really bad the other day. D plus for Joe Staley. All right, quickly, defensive grade here. We'll go Azeez Alshire, the linebacker out of FAU. A minus, looked really, really good in the time that he was on the field. We'll say this, Malcolm Smith and Dre Greenlaw looked really good as well. Smith was flying around the football. Greenlaw has been fantastic throughout training camp. But Azeez Alshire was really, really good against Denver. Had 5 tackles, 4 solo, and 1 pass defense. I would love for him to somehow make the squad. Whether that's practice squad, maybe extra special teams, I don't know. It's a crowded linebacker room, but at the same time, I think there's space for him. We'll have to wait and see, because when Warner's ready to go and Quan Alexander's ready to rock, and whoever plays the Sam, probably Malcolm Smith is there, it's a good linebacker core. It's probably a top 10 linebacker core. But at the same time, I'd like to have some backups in there. Greenlaw obviously is going to be there because they drafted him. But Azeez Alshire looked really, really good. I give him an A minus. And finally here, we got to do C.J. Beathard. I think C.J. Beathard's in a very important camp battle, especially with Jimmy Garoppolo looking rough this week and looking rough in training camp overall. I don't think he's fully healthy. C.J. Beathard gets a C minus because, again, the 5'11", the 81 yards, the 7.4 yards per attempt, the 70 quarterback rating, just throw it all out. Because what did he really do? His yards basically all came from Mostert screens. Especially that one on the right side, he ran for like 35, 40 yards, whatever it was. That was all Mostert. It was not C.J. Beathard. Here's the problem. There's only like 3 good throws, and one of them was dropped by Kendrick Bourne. Now, yeah, not C.J. Beathard's fault, but still, neither here nor there. The problem with C.J. Beathard, he was supposed to improve this offseason. This was the offseason where he's supposed to improve. He did not. He looks exactly the same. I don't know why they didn't play Nick Mullens more. Perhaps because they wanted to give Beathard one final chance. Didn't prove it. I expect to see a lot more Nick Mullens in the Week 3 preseason game. But yeah, it's very simple. C.J. Beathard, C- was not a very impressive day for him. He's fighting for the backup job. And honestly, I don't think he's going to win it. All right, overall grades. What do you guys think? I want your guys' thoughts on the 49ers overall grade against Denver. Go down below, type 49ers, colon, and the grade. That's simple. 49ers B, 49ers A, 49ers D, whatever you want. I want to gauge the fan base and how you guys feel about what the 49ers look like in Week 2. And of course, subscribe to our 49ers official chat sports page, www.chatsports.com/49ers. There it is. Go subscribe to it. Be sure to subscribe to Chat Sports here as well, as we have plenty of great content coming up in the future. All time we have for today, guys, for Chat Sports, I'm Thomas Motz signing off. Enjoy the rest of your day.